Hi, I'm Avinash Sajwan and welcome to my channel Engineers Mania. I am a postgraduate student from IIT Kharagpur. After the introduction of the landslides and rockfall, let's move on to this simulation using PFC. We can start by creating a project directory from the file menu and a new data file from the same menu from the title bar. After doing so let's begin with a new file and provide title to the project. And we will set a random number so that after multiple runs of the same model, the produced results are similar. That we can do by providing a model new command and a model random command, giving a random number and providing title as rockfall. Remember to put the title inside the parenthesis. And our first aim is to produce binary outputs of clump by importing the object files of clumps, and to do that we will import object files from the directory using geometry import commands. After importing the files, we need to generate clumps inside these geometries, and it can be done by using a bubble pack algorithm defined by TagAV in 2011 to generate the pebble distribution and use surf calculate keyword to calculate inertial attributes from surface description assuming uniform density. The impact and sensitivity of the keywords such as ratio and distance can be understood by using any geometry and changing values of these parameters. Here, ratio means the minimum and maximum radius of the pebbles, and distance refers to the angular smoothness. to check the impact of change in the values of parameters like distance and ratio, we plot the clump templates side by side for a comparison, and we see that which values are better suitable for our simulation. Like, we have plotted the clump templates according to their surface and pebbles inside them, and we can see the bottom range of clump templates having higher smoothness in comparison to the upper templates, because we have increased the distance parameter, and that's why the number of particles in the clump templates at the lower range, the number of particles is larger from the upper clump templates, which shows that the higher angular smoothness is achieved. But at the same time, if we use larger number of particles, the computational effort and the time will also increase. So to maintain this balance, we finally select the parameters according to our needs. Now we will export each clump template to a binary file and issue no throw or skip errors command, so that the overwriting is done for the pre-existing files. And this is how our first aim is achieved. Our second aim is to use brick logic to form a brick from clumps that makes the reproduction and computation fast. And for it, we will import the clump templates from the binary files and put them in a periodic cubic box and allow them to stabilize. Now we will provide density and initial damping to produce a mass of the clumps and provide the fractional content cumulative to 1 and group them accordingly. To form a grain size distribution curve, we will create a measure region inside the box and tabulate the particles according to their size in their respective bins with minimum and maximum extent, after which we will dump the table to form a table chart. We will use the time scaling to achieve equilibrium quickly, and after that we will set the time step back to auto mode. Now we will create and export a brick from the stabilized clump heap so that it can be utilized at later stage while it is replicated. We will define the domain dimensions and contact model along with its properties.
We will import the slope or mountain terrain as a wall using geometry import command, and I will share a different tutorial on how to generate this terrain geometry using Rhino. Here we will import the brick and assemble it in. And for our insight, the origin is the bottommost point from where the brick is replicated in axial directions. Here the size 222 means that it will be replicated twice in each x, y and z directions. We identify the clumps or the groups of clumps which are not required so that can be removed later on, and we will use clump delete command to remove these clumps. Now we create a box to contain and stabilize these initial rock fragments or debris. And to avoid model interference and better results, we will negate the body-based local damping and allow the clumps to settle in the box and save this state as state 4. After this, we will change the frictional properties of the slope and add the particle traces to the particle so that their positions in real time can be monitored, and we will save this as an initiation stage. As we know, the saved states are very large size files, thus we will use result logic to save miniature saved states which can be used later to generate images of the plots. And we will define a fish function to load the saved result files and generate the current plots to show the condition of the falling rocks in the real time. Now you can watch the video of landslide or a rockfall resulting from this data file, and thank you for watching this video.